Hey guys, Jody Hand here. I'm going to be doing a bunny with some strawberries tonight. And I worked on this sketch earlier today in my sketchbook. There's a lot of erasing lines, but I finally found a bunny that I liked and did some strawberries around the sides here. And then I just transferred just a little bit of the sketch with some water-soluble graphite pencil onto my Arches cold press paper, size 9x12. I'm going to be using my Shinhan watercolor tonight because if you had watched one of my previous videos, I had repanned, I guess would be the term, my Daniel Smith watercolor, so they are still drying and I didn't want to go into them until they were completely dry, so I'm just going to leave those sit to the side for a couple days. Like I said, I had done my sketch on my sketch pad and I transferred it with water-soluble graphite pencil, and then I just kind of erased it a little bit. It was a little dark. I'm gonna use some of this Van Dyke brown. All right, I think I'm gonna do the body first, just because the face has a lot more detail to it, and he's going to look kind of weird for a little bit while I'm working on the face. I haven't quite decided what I want to do the face. I have a little bit of white, lighter brown around his face here. Maybe a little bit more of a gray colored ear.
And the brush I'm using today is a Princeton Velvetouch round size 10.
I'm actually not putting any more pigment on my brush. I'm just going to just add a little more water and spread that around because I want his belly to be a little bit lighter here. And this is just my first layer. I'm going to be adding in the fur texture after this first layer is dry. So I'm mostly just concerned about getting a base wash across his body, and then I'll add in all my fur texture over the top. And then I did keep my sketch up on my desk just as a reference, see where I put some of the shadow lines and just to get a better idea of what I did with his face in case I lose some of my sketch. Just gonna blend that out a little bit. Ended up with a few little lines. brush has sticky stuff on it, sticking to my wrist. Alright, and any of those little imperfections I'll try to cover up when I'm adding my texture in later. Okay. He's looking like a brown blob at the moment. Alright, so I'm going to move on. I'm going to go on and do these ears. So I want to make this more of a gray-brown up here. And then I'll have some more of the gray. And then I'm going to come into a lighter brown and have some more white areas around his face and a white area around his eyes. Get some more of my... This was the Van Dyke brown. I really don't like these half pans. So I'm very happy I moved my Daniel Smith into fulls. Okay, and let's see. I don't really have a whole lot for sepia or anything, and this is just black. I'm assuming this brown is somewhat of like a sienna color, so maybe I will make my own gray this way. Sienna and the ultramarine. Okay, that's pretty good. Alright, and then I'm going to get ready before I go in there. I'm going to get some of this pink for inside the ears. And I think I'll use this Crimson Lake because that's probably what I'll end up using for my strawberries. So I'll get a little bit of that on there. Oh, and I did forget to mention, I was using a round size 10 for all of that. I'm sorry. All right, I might get some over here just really watered down. And I'm going to do the center of the ear first. Just lay that down, and then I can blend that in. And this one, just a little bit showing here. I'll take some of my gray. And that's okay if that blends together because I kind of want that fuzzy look. And then I will add more texture in when I get to my next layer. Van Dyke brown in here and get a little more brown. And being very careful around my eye here, I wanted to leave a little more white. And just getting some water on my brush and just kind of blending that down. And like I said, I wanted to do a bit more of like the white cheeks, so I'm actually gonna rinse my brush off, get some clean water, and just use that to kind of just blend that in. Do that again. So it's not stark white, but just a very, very light brown there. And I'm just going to blend out any of those watery lines that I'm ending up with here. Okay, so there's my first wash. That I'm gonna let that dry while this is fairly dry. I'm gonna go ahead and start doing my fur texture over the top of this. So to do that, I am actually gonna use these grainer brushes. I think I'm just gonna try to do it with this 1/4 inch filbert grainer first, and then if I need something a little bigger, I also have a 1/2 inch just flat grainer. So I'm gonna just try this one first and see if that gives me enough. And then I also have a round 4 and a round 1 and a dagger striper that I can try out too, just to add a little more texture. So I want to do in particular some fur right along here. There would be a darker spot here behind the leg and along these legs. So I'm going to use some of that same Van Dyke brown that I was using. And I also want to do this to go off the edge, just to add a furry edge. And the trick is to hold it at an angle. If you go straight like this, you're going to end up very straight. But if you hold at an angle and do very light little strokes, and you can get single, just going straight down, but I'm holding kind of at an angle here so that I get very light texture. Here, I'm actually going to take my 4, and I want to add a little bit of a darker wash along the bottom, below this chin here. Just kind of blend that down. Maybe add a little bit thicker lines along here too. Need some more my brown here. I'm just going to add a little bit darker here along the back and just kind of blend that down. And then just going to go just along the edge of where those legs are, just to kind of give that a little more definition. I'm going to wet my brush here and just kind of blend that in. Alright, so I want to add some texture lines going this way too. Oh shoot, I just totally splattered that all over there. Alright, if you make mistakes like this, you can get some clean water and lift it off with a paper towel. Luckily that didn't get too bad. Okay. Change the direction of that for right now. And I'm just going to go around the body and just kind of add a little bit of texture for fur. Coming off of each of the limbs here. this leg here and then the belly. I'm just kind of overlapping and going different directions a little bit just to give it a little more texture look. I'm gonna put some in this leg as well. All right, and I'm noticing I'm a little bit lighter than I would like up here on the face, so I am going to go ahead and just add some more. Use my 4 and mix up a little bit more of this gray. Get a little more brown to it. Okay. There and just mixing a little bit of that crimson with my gray just to kind of darken that up a little bit. Just letting that blend in there. Okay, and before that ear dries, I'm going to go ahead with my grainer, my filbert grainer brush here in my same color, and I just want to add the texture in here. I'm going to go upwards with this. Let's do the edge here. He's still looking pretty weird because I haven't done his eyes yet, so we'll be getting to that shortly. Alright, so now I want to add a little bit of layers around here just to give more definition through this middle part of his face. And just coming into that nose. I know, he looks very weird, and they will until you finish their eyes. It's That's why some people like to do the eyes first. They're not looking at like a weird looking animal. That's why it's helpful to have the sketch. You know what your grand plan is. Okay, and I just want to blend that. Some water. Okay, now I'm going to go and do that little bit of fur texture on that ear. The top of his head. And I'll go around the sides of his face here. I don't want to get too crazy, just enough there. Alright, and I do want to add just a little bit more around here just to give a little more shadow. Inside, I should have gotten just the tube of that out. Okay, so I want to just do a few stronger details here with this brown. Let's see, around his nose, it's getting dry. And then I wanted to do his paws here just to do those little lines. Okay, there he has some little toes now. Just going to define that leg just a little bit more. Okay, I am gonna go ahead and add in some whiskers and the eye. So I'll do the eye first. Use some black. And I'll leave that white circle for the center of the eye. I'm using a size 1 round brush here. It's starting to look more cute than creepy now. All right, I'm just gonna add very lightly, water this down here. And these little whisker dots. And I'm actually going to use my dagger striper so I get that very, very thin point here. And I don't want these to be very dark. I just want them very light hint of whiskers here. Some will be coming down and going up.
And for the whiskers here, I'm using my 1/4-inch dagger striper from the Princeton Velvetouch line, and I'm just making some quick strokes coming outward from those little dots I put on his cheeks and just sweep out with the black to make my whiskers. Right, and I think I'm done with that part of the bunny for right now, and I'm going to move on to the strawberries here.
first wash of the red. I use the Crimson Lake again. I'm gonna go ahead and let that dry so I can do my next layer over top. I'll do these little flowers. The centers of those are gonna be yellow. I'm gonna use this permanent yellow deep. And they're kind of a white flower, so I'm actually going to do very light gray for those. I'll let that yellow dry, and then in the meantime I'll work on these leaves and the stems. And I think I'm going to use this olive green. And I didn't draw the spikes that are like the spiny leaves that are of a strawberry. I just kind of drew the basic shape of them on here. But in my sketch, I did have the little spine. So I just want to use that, a little texture on my strawberry leaves. And then a technique that I like to use for doing the veins on my leaves that I don't know if you've seen in some of my other videos what I've done. As I turn my brush around, I use the base of the handle to kind of scratch or press into the paper, and then do that while it's still wet, then the paint will settle down into it. So you see it's already showing up. You can see the vein detail now. And I move on to my next one. And you want to make sure you do that while it's still wet. Don't wait for it to dry because it will not settle. You'll have to do another layer over the top if you wait. On top of my strawberries. I'm actually going to be doing some grass textures over the top of this, so I'm not too worried about the bottom of that. I'll go ahead and just work on my other one over here. And that leaf is kind of just hiding behind him. kind of lose my edge here on my leaves, so I might go back over that. I should have waited for that to dry. The flower, the yellow in the middle of my flower should be dry now, so I still have a little bit of that blue, ultramarine blue with that little bit of that brown. I'm just going to get very, very watered down gray. That's more on the blue side. And I'm just going to go and color in those petals as lightly as I possibly can. A little bit of my pencil line is still showing through, but that's okay. All right, and I just want to take my one here again and a little bit more of this yellow, and I just want to make some of the little flower stamen that come off of that, and just do very, very lightly a few little thin lines coming off that. And then continuing with my wine, I'm going to go back into my Crimson Lake and do my details on my strawberries. So I just want to do another wash over this center part where it would be the darkest. I'll let that dry and then I can go back and add my little seeds. I think my green is still wet, but I want to do just some grass. So I'm going to use this bigger grainer. Get a little bit more of my green here. Mix a little of that yellow in there just to give it a little color variation. And I just want to kind of make some grass and a little bit of ground here, so I'm going to use this grainer and hopefully I don't screw this up. So again, holding it at an angle here is very helpful. So I want to make kind of like a ground of where he's standing, and I'm going to just go back to my round 10, take a little bit of this brown, mix that with some of that green, and I just want to kind of just get a little bit of water in there and kind of mix that. Just do a light wash. I guess I should have done this grass before or after I did this, but that's fine. I can go back over it. Get that up a little bit. Sometimes you don't realize you need to do something until after you've already done another step, so. I will let that dry and then I can add some more grass back over it. going to use my grainer here again. Get some more of that green mixed with a little brown. Still a little wet, and that'll give me a nice fuzzy texture here. I'll wait for that to dry a little bit more and then I'll go back in. I'm going to go ahead and go back over my strawberry leaves here just a little bit more, just to define those edges. I think I am going to also just do a little bit of detail here on my petals. I'm gonna get my one, go back with that gray again, and just kind of, oops, that's a little too dark. Just blend that out a tiny bit. And I'm gonna do my strawberry seeds. Same Crimson Lake again. And I'll just do, I'll add just a tiny bit of that black to it. Caring for how stark white I made that. So I'm just going to blend that a tiny bit. There. Alright, I'm going to add some more grass. Just varying the direction I'm doing my grass blades here.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel today. I'm adding new tutorials all the time. And if you want to share your painting with me, I'd love to see it. You can tag me on Instagram with Mrs. Hand Painted and my hashtag Mrs. Hand Painted. Have a great day.